Namaste students, myself Sunil Kumar from the Department of Computer Science. Today we are moving to the next session based on the chapter Data Handling. Already we know that we discussed one session based on the data handling. Mainly data handling deals with the data, different types of data types. So already in previous session we mainly discussed about what are the different types of data types. So in case of Python program, there are different core type data types are there. There are different core or we can say the built-in data types. One is numbers. Number is the one built-in data type. Next one is the string. String is the one more type of built-in data type. List. List is the one more type. Tuple and also the list. These are the mainly five types of built-in data types available in Python. And in previous session mainly we discussed about different types of numbers or number data types. In that integers and after complex numbers and also the floating point. So if we take the numbers, numbers mainly are of three types of number data types are available. One is floating point, complex numbers and also the integer data type. Then if you go into the integer, integer is again divided into two types, which is a boolean data type and also the integers, signed integers, or we can say signed or unsigned integers, plus or minus. So these we discussed in a previous session and also we just started with the strings. For example, if you are going to discuss different types of integer or complex types, or if you are going to discuss it floating point, there is no limit for that. There is no limit is there to store the data. Limit is available based on the virtual memory. Memory available based on the memory limit will be there. Only limit is there only in case of boolean values. Limit is 2, because only 2 values are there, either true or false. True is known as 1, false means that will be 0. That is in case, only in that case value will be there or length will be there. Other than any other case, there is no particular range is provided in case of Python different types of data types. So next we will move to the second type, strings. Already in previous session I explained what is a string. So string is string can hold any type of non-character. So take the string. String is a one more type of data type or core data type, or we can say built-in data type. That can hold any kind of non-character. Remember non-character here. Non-character as well. What do you mean by non-character? So if you take any programming language, if you're going to take Python, if you're going to take any other C++, Java, or any other programming language, different types of programming language, one thing you have to keep it in mind. So if all the symbols or the characters, whatever it is not possible to understand by the computer or programming language. Now if you take the one programming language, some set of character or some set of numbers or some set of special character can be understood by the particular programming language. So that is the known characters for the particular programming language. So here if you take the Python cannot understand all the languages. Python cannot understand all the languages, but it can understand only some symbols. Only some symbols. By using that symbol, you have to write the program. So symbols means that is known as known character, which can recognize by the particular programming languages. Characters or symbols that can be recognized by the particular programming language, that is known as known characters. So in that known characters here, numbers, letters and special characters are there. If you are going to take string contains numbers, letters and also the special characters. So whenever if you are going to declare the string should be declared within a double quotes. String should be declared within a double quotes, that is about the strings. All these first topics we discussed in a previous session. Now we will see how to work with the strings. So whenever you are going to take the string, remember one thing here. String as a sequence of character. Remember, always if you are going to take, string is always in the form of sequence of character. Or you can say, a Python string is a sequence of a character. Python string is a sequence of a character. Multiple characters are combined together. Multiple characters are combined together. That we can say as a one string. So each character can be accessed by using this index. If you have to access each character, I told if you take the string, string is a sequence of characters. Multiple characters are combined together. So that is actually the string. So whenever string is there, means how we can access the strings? Whenever if you want to access the string, that can be accessed by using the index. So what is the index here? For example, so name. If you assign name is equal to computer, name is equal to computer, just you assign, or you can fix subject, give it a subject. You assign that computer is a subject. So remember, whenever if you are going to as I explained, either it is a double code or it is a single code. But not like in other programming. Other programming language, if you use a single code, only character is possible. If you use a double code, only strings are possible. Here it is suggesting single code or the double code to assign the value. So if you assign the values like this, whenever you are going to assign the values like this, automatically it will create a memory space. Automatically it is going to create a memory space. 1, 4, C, first character, next O, next M, next P, next U, T, E, and last is R. So these are the memory space will be created. To hold each value, it will create a memory space. So here we are going to create a subject. This is the subject. Subject is this one. So it will create a memory space like this, or we can represent like that, or we can say we can represent the data like that. So whenever you are going to store the data like this, whenever you are going to store the data like this, so you should access the data. Whenever you want to access the data, mainly we are making use of index. Index means it's a values, locations. Index means there's a location of the each character. Location of each character, that is known as index. Location of each character is known as index. So index is always start from 0, normally 0. Starting location of the character or address, or it is a location, starting index always 0, then 1, next 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. These are the total length, or it is a total number of index. So by using this index, we can access the data. So if you are going to use subject of 0. What is the subject of 0? In case of strings, normally if you want to access the data, mainly we are making use of square brackets. Square bracket here is known as subscript. By using the subscript, we can access the data. So if you have subject of 0 means that is C. That is equal to C character C. The next subject of 1, that is 0, O. Subject of 2, that is M. Subject of 3, that is T. Subject of 4, that is 2. Subject of 5, that is T. 6, that is E. Subject of 7, that is R. So based on the string name, we can give the subject value, different subject. That is one thing. So that type of number from 0 to 7, that is known as forward index. From 0 to 7, we are using that, we can say that forward index. But in case of Python, one more type of indexing is possible. This type of indexing, forward indexing, is there in all other programming languages. But if it is a Python, one more type of indexing is there, that is known as backward indexing. So backward indexing, it starts from the last character. Towards left by putting the value minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, and minus 3. These are known as backward indexing. Whenever you provide the minus values, from the last character, provide the minus values, that is known as backward indexing. Whenever if you want to give the 0 to end value, starting value to next value, positive numbers, means that is known as forward indexing. These are the mainly two types of indexing available in case of Python. So subject of 0 is C. Subject of minus 7, that is also C, capital C, or C, character is same. 0 and 2, not 7, minus K. This is minus K. Subject of 0 and subject of minus 8, both also C. Subject of 1 and subject of minus 7, in this case will be C. That is based on the length. For example, if you store the computer, is like that. Whenever you are going to use one more type of character, I use one more thing here. If I use Python, so it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. backward indexing starts from minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and minus 6. So backward indexing and forward indexing based on the numbers. So how we can take a total length? So this is about the forward indexing and backward indexing. After that, how we can find the total length of the variable? Whenever variable is x, how we can study the, how we can check the total length of the variable? Whenever we are going to check the total length, we can make use of one function. We can make use of one function. That function is known as length function. We can make use of length function. Length, we can give the subject. For example, x equal to length of subject. Length is the function that is used to find the total length of the particular string. If you want to find the total length of the particular string, we are making use of length function. So detail we are going to study in next upcoming chapter. One chapter is the strings. String chapter is the, at that time we are going to study about this one detail. Just you understand what is string. String is a 1-1-1 data type. There is a sequence of character. String is a sequence of character, and each character can be accessed by index. Each character can be accessed by the index values. Here index values, there are two types of indexing is there. One is forward indexing and one more is backward indexing. Two types of indexing is available. One is forward and one more is backward indexing. Forward starts from 0 to n and backward starts from minus 1 to n minus or length, minus length. So that is the total length, will be there, so minus length. So this is the indexing in case of Python program. This is about the string data type. And one more thing here, if you want to find the total length, you want to find here minus length. So minus index will start from minus 1 to minus length. Minus length. What is the length? Length we can find is by using the length function, we can find the total length. By using the length function, we can find the total length. So this is about we are going to study later, just more about in the chapter of string chapter, we are going to study these things detail. Now, just one introduction about the strings. Now, we will move to the one more type of data type, that is list. Already told, core data types or fundamental data types, what we are saying. That is, one is, first is numbers, then strings. The next type of fundamental data type, that or we can say built-in data type, that is list. In case of Python, list means we can hold the different types of values. Multiple values can be held inside single variable. As a string also same thing, here also same thing. But in case of list, it is a Python's compound data type or compound data type. We can say that is actually known as list. List can be changed or modified. Remember, if you use the list, it can be changed or modified once you add one data to a list. Later on, if you want to change the data, that is possible in case of list. Like a string only. String is not possible, data in between. If you want to change the data, not possible. Entire data is possible to change. But in between, if you want to change single data, that is not possible in case of strings. But that is possible in case of list. And when it's going to hold the data, it can hold different types of data type. It can hold the different type of data type. And remember, it can be changed or modified. Data can be changed inside the list, which data you want to store. That data can be changed or modified. So that type of data is known as list, and it is also known as mutable. Mutable means same. Data can be changed or modified. Once you store the data, that data can be changed or modified. So here, take a list. A list is a Python represents a list, comma separated values of any data type within the square brackets. So what do you mean by list? List is a different data types value or different data types. Either we can use strings, we can use, or we can use pointer values or fraction values, we can use, or integers we can use, or else we can complex numbers. Anything is possible. The different data types also combine inside the list, and it should be comma separated. That all the values should be separated by the comma separated values of any data type. Any data type also we can use. For example, we can use integers, complex numbers, strings, or anything, whatever it may be, it can be used anything, and that should be lies within the square bracket. That is actually known as list. So list is a Python's list. In Python's represent list of comma separated values. Remember, I say list of comma separated values of any data type. Any data type, that is important. Any data type, and between, that should be lies between the square brackets. Example, this is one string. This is what I can say, one list.
So if you are to take one more example, I will use 10.12.3518.6. This is one more type example, one more type of issue. So here, in this case, only integers are there, but here integers floating point, integers one more floating point, like that also here. So any type, you can use any type of data types. One more example is double quote Neha. This is a string data type. Second is 10, then A, then 56.3. So this is one more type of data type. All the data types in the one more list, that all the data types are there. So this is possible in case of list. This is possible. So multiple data types can be had, can handle multiple data types in case of list. So that is actually list, and that should be separated by the comma. And remember, when you are going to declare, when you are going to use this one in a program, so we can use like this. We have to say A is equal to list, list name. Just example, leave that one. Just one example here. Okay? When you are going to declare or create the list, list can be created, A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So when you create like this, automatically it will take the values here. Automatically it will take the values. It will create the values 1, 2, 3, and 4. Automatically store the values. So already discussed in case of list or strings, we discussed. It uses index values 0, 1, 2, 3. It uses an index values. Same index values also here we use. Then if you are going to display, just if you use print, A if you use print A, that list will be same list will be displayed 1, 2, 3, 4. Same will be displayed. It will be displayed same. And after that, if you want to change any data, for example, I don't want this one, I want to change this one another way. That is possible. That is possible in case of list. So we can change. If you want to change the values, so I can change here A of 0. A of 0 means this one. First one 0, 1, 2, 3. A of 0. If you give as 10. A of 0 equal to 10 means then list automatically will change. List automatically will change. That is actually known as mutable. That is known as mutable. It's possible to change the data. Once if you store the data, later on if you want to change the data, that is possible. That is actually known as mutable. So here if you give A of 0 means in index value 0, data will change. Then if you are going to print A, if you are going to print A, it will print 10. 2, 3, 4. Any data like this, any data is possible to change. Any data is possible to change in case of list. So later one more example is a list, in that we have discussed about list name. So just I told how, what is a list and how we can use the list. And remember one thing mainly here is a mutable. Data can be changed in case of list. Next we will move to the one more type of data type, that is a tuple. Already we discussed about the list, and next we will move to the tuples. And remember, tuples and list almost same, but a small difference. Small difference is mutable and immutable. Let's see one by one here. List is a Python compound data type. So list also Python's compound data type. And if you go in with the tuples, tuples is also the Python's compound data type. So these are both also same, but main difference here is tuples cannot change or modify. Remember, list can be changed or modified once if you enter the data. Later on, it's possible to change. For example, last case I told 1 if given, it's possible to change as 10, or any value can be changed by using the index values. But that is not possible in case of tuples. Tuples cannot be changed or modified, or we can say that it is immutable. Also, we can say that one as immutable means a data or value if you store, that is not possible to change. That is actually known as immutable. Then tuples are represented as a group of comma separated values. List also is represented as a comma separated values. But remember one thing here, and of any data type. Same thing. Same as list here. Till here the same. Tuples are the represented as group of comma separated values of any data type. List also same thing. List also group of comma separated values of any data type. But one thing here, tuple should be represented within a parenthesis. If you go for list, list should be represented in a square brackets. Remember, list should be there within a square bracket. If you are going with the tuples, tuple should be represented within a parenthesis. Parenthesis means normal brackets. This is normal. Normal brackets in case of Python is known as parenthesis. For example, 1, 2,
an example. So any value is represented within a square normal parenthesis, that is actually known as tuples. So another more example, 10, 10.5, 20, 20, 25.6. This is one more type of data type, one more value. So here it is, floating point is an integer. This gives all the integers, but in integers, floating point, both also there. So multiple data type is possible, or any data type there. Remember, same as list, here also possible to store any data type. The next one here is, same thing here is, Neha. Double quote. Then, 10, 25.6. So one more value. This is also possible. So whether you're going to use different values, that is also possible. Or instead of multiple values, you can use A, single code, B, that also possible. Single character is also possible. So this is actually known as tuples. But one thing here, if you use a tuples, it's not possible to change the value. Once if you store the value, that cannot be changed. Then how we can use this one? How we can use this one in a program? Whenever if you're going to use this in the program, just use P is equal to 1, variable is equal to, if you assign the value like this. P is equal to, you can assign one value. So this is about the tuples. And one more chapter is here. In that chapter, we are going to discuss detail about tuples. Just here, I just started with the tuples, what is a tuple, and you have to understand the concept. Or you have to understand the day, one more data type is there. For that purpose, I used this type of tuples here. So the next upcoming chapter, we are going to detail discussing about the tuple. How we can work out, how we can use that in a program, everything elicited in upcoming chapters. Now we will move to the last type of data type, that is a dictionary. So already we discussed strings, list, tuples, and last one here is a dictionary. Dictionary is also same as list of, we can say almost same as list and tuple. It is an unsorted set of comma separated values. Remember, it is unsorted, there is no sorting order, there is no order here. But it's a comma separated values like that, like a list of tuples. Dictionary is also a comma separated value. And remember, here is actually two values, key and value. Remember, each value, each data should contain two parts. One is key and value, and that should be separated by columns, and it's a pairs of that one. Pairs of key and value within a one more type of brackets. So, list should be represented within a square brackets. If you are going to tuple, that is immutable, and should be represented within a parenthesis. If you are going with the dictionary, that should be represented within open flower bracket and closing flower brackets. Normally say flower brackets, but that is actually known as dictionary. And remember, no two keys should be same. In case of list, or in case of dictionary, we are accessing the data based on the key. So key should be unique value. Key should be the unique value. No two keys should have the same values. No two keys should have the same values. That type of data is known as dictionaries. So we'll take an example. So before taking example, so that should be represented in square of flower brackets. The first place, first you have to provide the key, then column, next you have to provide value. First. Second one is also same thing. Second one. Key, next you have to provide value. Like that, you have to provide the multiple values that should be given inside the brackets or flower brackets. Okay, this and each pair should be separated by the commas. Each pair should be separated by comma. Or this is actually known as dictionaries. So when you are going to take an example, so I'll use B is equal to a dictionary I will give, or D. Any other value I can give. So I will use vowels. Vowels equals to open flower bracket. A key as one. One I give, one, then there is A. One means A. Two means I can use E. Three, I can give I. Single quote I. Four, I can use four. Next, five, I can use. So this is actually known as dictionaries. So normally this here in this case 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are actually known as keys. And these are A, E, I, O, U. These are actually known as values. You can keep opposite manner also. You wish. Keys always should not be integers. or value should not, value should not be a string sample. You can give anything, that is possible.
But when you going to access this one, when you going to access vowels
of,
vowels of,
if I use one, if you going to print this one, it will print A. That will be A.
Vowels of,
two if I use, that will print E. Like that, it is possible to display the different values based on the key value, based on the key values. Remember, two keys, for example, this one more one is not possible. Here is not possible to give as well. But two values can be same, that is possible. Two values can be same, but two keys should not be same. Two keys should not be same. That is the main thing in case of dictionaries. So, these are about the dictionaries. In upcoming chapter, one more chapter is there. In that, we are going to discuss detail about the dictionaries. So, upcoming chapters are like this. One is for strings. Strings, one chapter is there. List, one more chapter is there. Tuples is one more chapter. Dictionaries is also one more chapter. There are different chapters are there. In that chapter, we are studying these data types in detail. In detail, we are going to study that one. So, just here you have to understand. Dictionary is an unsorted set of comma separated. Key value pairs, is a key value pairs, and within dot brackets, and two keys should not have the same values, and is an example to discuss the dictionaries. Based on this one, here we reach the end of session. In this session, we mainly discussed about the different types of data types, mainly strings we discussed, and after strings, string if you take a forward indexing, and also backward indexing is there. After that, we started with the one more type, that is a list. This is the one more type, and after that, we finished with one more type of data type, that is a tuples, and finally, we reached here is the dictionaries. Based on this one, I will give the worksheet, work out that one. So, we will meet in next session. Thank you.